Let's look at the following math story. Calvin and his family are having a garage sale this weekend. He made a sign to direct customers, and he wants to place a red tape around the sign to make it more visible. How much red tape will he need for the sign? Calvin needs to find the perimeter of his sign. Perimeter is the distance around a figure. We can add the length of all the sides of a figure to find its perimeter. Calvin's sign has 7 sides. To find the perimeter for Calvin's sign, we can add the length of the 7 sides. Wait, Calvin only has the length of some of the sides, but not all of them. I got an idea. We can use the geometric attributes of figures to find the lengths we are missing. These 2 sides are congruent, which means they are the same size. Then the other side measures 6 inches as well. These 2 sides are also congruent. These 2 sides are congruent, but we don't know the length of these sides. Wait, we see that the trunk of the arrow is formed by 3 squares of the same size. The attribute of a square is that all its sides are congruent, the same size. We see that we have this length. If the square's sides are the same measurement, then we also see that the 3 squares are congruent, or the same size. Then the length of the other square's sides are the same as well. This means that one side of the arrow's trunk is 10 inches plus 10 inches plus 10 inches, which is the same as 30 inches. These 2 sides are congruent, so both sides measure 30 inches. Now we have the length of all sides of Calvin's sign. Let's add all the sides. 10 inches plus 30 inches plus 30 inches plus 6 inches plus 6 inches plus 15 inches plus 15 inches. We can add the doubles first. 30 plus 30 equals 60. 6 plus 6 equals 12. 15 plus 15 equals 30. Now, we can add the partial sums using the standard algorithm. We know that Calvin needs 112 inches of red tape for his garage sale sign. We hope Calvin's garage sale is successful. Today, we've learned how to calculate the perimeter of a figure. Keep up the great work, scholars!